Thurlin Kearney at NFI Radio. And we thank God for all that he's doing in gospel preaching, teaching, and singing. Here at the Lincoln Park Holiness Church, we believe in God-powered preaching, sound doctrine, teaching, compassionate reaching, and hallelujah praise. Come on, church, say it with me. We believe in what?
Hallelujah
praise. Give God some praise. Hallelujah praise. He's worthy to be praised. So we believe in loving people and helping communities. So I thank God for all of the ministerial staff, the deacons, the trustees, and all of the volunteers, saints, and friends. And we greet you in the powerful and penetrating name of our Lord on this day. So at this time, we're going to have some Black History presentations. And we're going to have, we have two young men, and we're going to ask them if they can come at this time.
My name is Austin Williams, and I'm doing a presentation on LeBron James and how he did go. LeBron James, he's an 18-time All-Star. Well, he's been to the All-Star game about 18 times.
Mm-hmm.
He's been in his career like 19 times. He missed out on his rookie year. He's a four-time NBA champ and I think a four-time MVP.
Okay. They said a child shall lead them. The young man had a lot of wisdom and wanted to be saved, and I applaud him for that. Okay, our next young man, he can come.
Hello, my name is Aiden Williams, and for my Black History Month presentation, I'm doing Russell Wilson and how he's very good for his height. So he inspires me because I want to play football, but I think I'm too short to do anything. But he's short and he's doing a lot of great stuff, so I think I can do it too.
I love it. You know, young men. Again, we want to thank God for their grandmother, Tammy Holden, who grew up in this church, and her mother, Irene Holden. So we have the grandson and the great grandsons of members here at Lincoln Park, participating in our Black History Month service. So pray with me this morning as we come to do what thus says the Lord. As an author and activist, James Weldon Johnson brought attention to current issues of lynching and racism that were very prevalent during the times in which he lived. He believed that the arts and literature could elevate and reflect the true genius of a people. He was an avid Bible reader. So being a Bible reader and believing in the arts and literature, elevating and reflecting the true genius of a person, I do believe that he also believed what the Bible says, as Paul said, that he that begun a good work in you shall perform it unto the day of the Lord. God is working in you, every one of you, all of us have something in us, gifts and talents. Some of them have been lurking below. Some of them have been hid. Some of them, maybe shyness or bashfulness or fear or whatever, some of those gifts are still inside and need to be birthed out from you to the world to help make the world a better place. Can I get a witness? So he was a man, James Weldon Johnson was a man of many talents. Not only was he a distinguished lawyer and diplomat, he also was executive director of the NAACP for over a decade. This man was a very outstanding individual during a period what they call the Harlem Renaissance, which we may talk about that sometime later on in another message. But he was a composer. So, and as a composer, he is the one that wrote the lyrics to the song "Lift Every Voice and Sing," which is known as our Black National Anthem. Also, his poem, "The Creation," was written in his mind in the tradition of a Negro sermon. So today, I would like to share that with you. Pray for me as we attempt to share the Negro sermon "Creation" as written by James Weldon Johnson. And it goes like this: "And God stepped out on space, and he looked around and said, 'I'm lonely. I'll make me a world.' And as far as the eye of God could see, darkness covered everything, blacker than 100 midnights down in a cypress swamp. Then God smiled, and the light broke, and the darkness rolled up on one side, and the light stood shining on the other. And God said, 'That's good.' Then God reached out and took the light in his hands, and God rolled the light around in his hands until he made the sun, and he set that sun ablazing in the heavens. And the light that was left from making the sun, God gathered it up in a shining ball, and he flung it against the darkness, spangling the night with the moon and the stars. Then down between the darkness and the light, he hurled the world. And God said, 'That's good.' Then God himself stepped down, and the sun was on his right hand, and the moon was on his left. The stars were clustered about his head, and the earth was under his feet. And God walked, and where he trod, his footsteps hollowed the valley out and bulged the mountains up. Then he stopped and looked and saw that the earth was hot and barren. So God stepped over to the edge of the world. He spat out the seven seas. He batted his eyes and the lightnings flashed. He clapped his hands and the thunders roared. And the waters above the earth came down. The cooling waters came down. Then the green grass sprouted and the little red flowers blossomed. The pine tree pointed his finger to the sky. And the oak spread out his arms. The lakes colored around the hollows of the ground. And the rivers ran down to the sea. And God smiled again. And the rainbow appeared and cuddled itself around his shoulder. Then God raised his arm and he waved his hand over the sea and over the land. And he said, 'Bring forth, bring forth.' And quicker than God could drop his hand, fishes and fowls and beasts and birds swam the rivers and seas, roamed the forests and the woods, and split the air with their wings. And God said, 'That's good.' Then God walked around, and God looked around on all that he had made. He looked at his sun, and he looked up at his moon. He looked at his little stars, and he looked on his world with all its living things. And God said, I'm lonely still. Then God sat down on the side of the hill where he could think. By a deep, wide river, he sat down with his head in his hand. God thought and thought till he thought, I'll make me a man. Up from the river, the bed of the river, God scooped the clay. And by the bank of the river, he kneeled down. And there the great Almighty God, who lit the sun and fixed it in the sky, who flung the stars to the most far corner of the night, who rounded the earth in the middle of his hand. This great God, like a mammy bending over her baby, kneeled down in the dust, toiling over a lump of clay till he shaped it in his own image. Then into it, he blew the breath of life, and man became a living soul. Amen. Amen. And say amen again. Now all stand to your feet and give God total praise. Today, and at this time, we're going to pray for the world, we're going to pray for this city, and we're going to put up a special prayer for your dad. I'm going to ask Evangelist Anthony Evans to come.
God. Gracious Lord God, as we come before your throne, because right now we come with an emergency. We come because a child has come to ask that we pray for his father. Father, 911 is the number for emergencies here on earth. But we're going to use it right now because we find that it's an emergency situation that a young man has come before your throne because you said anyone could come and ask the desires of their heart. And you could be more gracious enough to give us those desires. Right now that this young warrior comes, that we ask, that we petition your throne in behalf of his father. Father, right now only you know what the situation is regarding this young man's father. We pray right now that you come see about him right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And Father, there's others right now who have situations that need to be petitioned before your throne of grace, Father, but they won't speak out. We pray right now that you come see about them. Touch right now from the crown of their heads to the soles of their feet. There's others, Father, who have health issues. Father, we pray right now that you heal. Touch right now. Father, there's an elderly statesman among us who celebrated a birthday on yesterday. 86 years, if I'm not mistaken. And Father, he's willing to dance in the aisles even on this day. We pray right now, Father, that you'll continue to restore and repair everything that the enemy is trying to take away, that he might continue to dance down the aisles and even show us all that you are still large and in charge, that you are the master of the miraculous. And we pray right now that you will continue to heal us all of our infirmities, restore and repair. We pray right now that you'll bless our pastor, fill him with your unadulterated gospel, bless his family. And then, Father, we pray right now that you'll bless all the congregation and the disciples and the families of Lincoln Park Holiness Church, as well as your children everywhere. Then, Father, bless that one that's asked God, pray for me. Then, Father, bless this nation. Heal us of this dreaded coronavirus. And then, Father, every other infection and disease everywhere. Then, Father, penetrate our hearts and our minds with your word, that we might hide it in our hearts, that we might not sin against thee. Then love us, Father, continue to love us, and we shall be loved. Bless us, and we shall be the love. Then, Father, take us through this day according to your will and your way. Anoint us afresh. And continue, Father, to bless this young man. Anoint him afresh, that he might continue to lead his family and his household as you would have us to go. For this is our prayer. In Jesus' mighty name we do pray. Let the redeemed of the Lord say amen.
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 And amen.
Amen. Glory to God.
Lincoln Park Holiness Church is about loving people and helping community. Our main objective is winning souls. You are welcome to partner with us or help sponsor this ministry and broadcast with a donation. Please visit our website at lincolnparkchurch.com and click the Let's Give tab at the top of the screen. Feel free to leave comments. You can also download the Givelify app on your mobile phone and look for Lincoln Park Church. Cash App, hashtag Lincoln Park CRF. We are located at 13 Heath Street in Raleigh, North Carolina. God bless you, and we look forward to you joining us next week on NFI Radio and Catch the Wave from the number one radio station reaching the world with gospel music and preaching.